Okay, so first thing you should know how to create account in Git. So first you will go to github.com. For me, I have already account, so you can see I title login inside my account, but in your case you need to create account. But most of you should have Git account. If you don't have, then what will be process, go to this particular page and you will get sign up option. Click on this. Here they will ask few details, enter your email. Okay, let me use one email since I will use this thing for demo. So I will use this email ID. Password. Username. Would you like to receive product update? No. Verify account, start puzzle, spiral galaxy. Okay, account verify, create account. So it's asking me to save. I will save this credential. So they sent one OTP. 9017702. 9017702. Okay, so welcome to GitHub. How? Okay, so they are asking few details, how many team member will be working with you. So let's take 50 plus student. Are you a student or teacher? Let's say teacher. Continue. What specific feature are you interested in using this? So I'm using this CI/CD, security, no, client app, no, project management, team administration, community, no, continue. Then real world tool, engage students. So they are asking about different like pricing and all. So we are going to use free one. So in free account we can do 2000 action in a month. We can have 500 MB of storage. Okay, so I will select free account. So they are initializing my dashboard and my dashboard is ready here. Okay, so in this dashboard, like at this moment I don't have anything. Okay, so that's why I can't see anything here, like repository or project, nothing is here. So what I will do, first I will create repository, I will create project, sorry, I will create organization, then I will create repository, and then I will show you how you can invite other member. So this is not my main account, just now I created. So what I will do, I will log in with my main account and I will do all the operation. Or I have my main account in different browser. Let me open that one. Okay, so let me log in. So this is my main account. Okay, and here I will do all this setup since I am going to use, I want to maintain same account. But there I explain how you can create account. Okay, now you are in this page, now my account is ready. So first thing you need to do, you need to create organization. Okay, in this case here you can't see any organization, but in my case I can see organization. Why I can see? Since I have already created organization, I can click on this and I can go to organization. But in your case, if organization is not there, you want to create organization, go to your profile and so new project. Wait a minute. So organization option you will able to see here. Let me go back again and let me explain again. So if you are creating fresh account, okay, so just now I created one project, so now I can see one project, but I will create organization. Okay, so to create organization, what you need to do, first you need to go inside settings. Okay, inside settings you will get option of organization, and here they are asking about organization name. Okay, so by default, like I am taking this Kumar Mule Training 1 as a organization. If you want, you can create new organization. Okay, so you want to use Team 1, I want to use Free 1. Okay, so create free organization. So here you need to give organization name. Let me use demo. Contact email. So this is my personal account, or I can select this business account, belongs to MuleSoft, verify account, Spiral. Okay, and then okay, organization account name, this one is already taken. Okay, so I need to take some random one. I am taking this one. Okay, click on next. So in this way you can create one organization, and inside this organization you can add multiple members. Okay, so if I want, I can add members here, that I will do later on. Skip this step at this moment. Okay, for which purpose you are creating organization, you need to write code, planning code, then how many team size, 25, then other option you need to select. Okay, so only thing was challenging here in new account, how you will get organization. So you need to select inside setting option. Once you will create first time, then it will be visible here. Okay, so since as I mentioned, like this is not my main account, so I will do everything in main account, then I will give access to this account. Okay, since I want to maintain everything in one place. Okay, so here what I will do, first I will create one organization for this particular batch. Okay, so based on my previous batches I created a different organization, so I will create new organization. So free one, account name, this will be banking project, customer onboarding. Okay, contact email, okay, and this is my business, MuleSoft. Verify, spiral, next. So I created this organization, and here they are asking which email ID you want to invite, means which user you want to add. So I will add everyone, okay, that I will do later on. For now I am adding only one account what I have in different browser. So for this account I am giving access, okay. For everyone I will collect email ID and I will give access to everyone later on. I will do it later on. For now I am giving to this account. Now complete setups. So I will use this all, then team size 25 plus, personal education project, no, manage code, collaborate code, plan and track works, CI/CD, no, do you have any existing repository, I will put no, submit. So what it will do, it will create one organization for me. Now inside this organization you can see at this moment I have given access to only one person, okay. Now if you will go to here, so for this email ID I have given access, so this email ID received one invitation. Same way I will add everyone email one by one. By tomorrow I will add everyone email, so everyone will get this email. So what you need to do, go inside this mail and you need to click on this particular, you need to click on this particular link, okay. So before that what you need to do, you need to install one more software. So what software you need to install, you need to install Git Desktop. This software you need to install, so you will click on this download for your operating system. For me it's coming from Mac, but for you it will come Windows. So you will download this software and you will click on that downloaded file, it will install that software. Once it will be installed, it will look like this. Let me log out so you will get same user interface. Okay, so it will be blank for you. So what you need to do, you need to log in. So where you will do login, in case, in your case I think, yeah, you also need to go in preference, okay. Go to preference and then here it will ask for sign in option. So enterprise you will not select, since we don't have enterprise license, we will select github.com. click on sign in, then it will ask continue with browser, so click on this. It will go to browser and it will ask to authorize desktop. So at this moment I have logged in with my new account what I created with Kumar Mule Training 1, okay, new account. So it will logged in with new account. Again it logged in with old account. let me check which account is logged in here. Okay, this one is Kumar Mule Training 1. Okay, and in Git. Okay, yeah, same account is there. So using that account, I logged in. Okay, so.
Sorry, I'm disconnected. Can you repeat what you said? What you did?
Okay. So how you can do login?
Yeah, I didn't see the Git. What you did on Git?
Okay. So. Actually here this user interface is a bit different since I am already logged in. So let me try to create same interface what you will get if you are using first time. So how I can get that one? Actually this for you, actually this interface will be a bit different. There you need to select different option. So
are you using the command line or Windows interface?
No, it's a Windows interface. Okay, at this place what I will suggest, one person need to share your screen, then we will get same interface what other person will see. Is there anyone who don't have git account? Is there anyone? Can you speak a bit louder? Is there anyone who don't have Git account?
Yes, I don't have, sir.
Okay. So what you need to do? Share your screen. Are you sharing your screen?
Yes, doing, sir. Your entire screen, isn't it?
Yes. Okay, so first go to your browser. First download one Git desktop software. Parallelly you can start downloading Git desktop. Select first option. Select GitHub desktop sample. Yeah. Click on download.
Yeah, it's downloading.
Okay, just now you created Git account also, correct?
Yes, sir.
Okay, can you go to your Git account? Third tab. Yeah.
Actually, no, I have taken customer module.
Okay, then you have already account. Okay, so you haven't used Git desktop, then fine. Okay, no problem.
Yes.
Just give me this username or email address so I can give you access of new project.
Okay, email,
anything, email or this username, anything should be fine.
If this is the username, wasn't
Yeah, send me in chat, send me in this Google Meet chat. Now go to your screen, git desktop screen. Check that software is downloaded or not.
Yes sir, downloading.
Open this file.
Run it.
Yes, run it. What happened? It's completed. Go to your search. Go to search option. Yeah, type git desktop. Git space desktop. No, it's not downloaded. Can you open that link again? Okay. Sorry. Now exe file is there. Now click on that exe file. Okay. Click on run.
Yeah, it is setup is completing.
Okay. Yeah. Cancel this one. Whatever you can see on top of your screen, cancel this one. Yeah. Okay.
Yeah, wait. Okay.
So for you guys, like if you are completely new on Git desktop, then you will get this interface. In mine case, like I was getting different interface, but in your case, you will get this interface. So what you need to do, you need to click on sign in to github.com. Click on that sign in to github.com. Okay.
Address desktop.
Okay, for you also it's same only. Okay, I also got same interface now. Okay, fine. Click on authorize desktop. So this will take few seconds. Okay, now here you need to put your name is already there. Okay, no need to change. For email you can see drop down, select your proper email. In drop down you will get your proper email ID also. And click on finish. Yes, now wait here. So now what I will do, I will give access of new project, okay, new organization. Okay. What I created. So you already shared your mail ID. I will send you one meeting invite. Just wait for a few seconds. I will send you git invite, just wait for few seconds. So invite member. I am giving you access as a member, so you will have only read access, you will not able to write. Okay, so access given to you. Now go to your email. Go to your email. Are you there?
Yes, sir. It is. Open it.
Okay.
Join banking project.
Yes, wait. I can't see your next screen. Okay. I think there is some problem. Oh, sorry. Yeah, I can see. Yes, so inside your mail you got one invitation. Now click on that invitation. Yeah, correct. Okay, now select green option, join option. Yes, so you can see now whatever like repository I created, now you also have that access. So in that repository we are two people, one I am as a admin and you are as a member. Okay, yes. Okay, so now what I will do, you are synced with this Git desktop also. Can you go to Git desktop?
Yeah.
Okay, so what you need to do, clone a repository from the internet, select second option. So here, yes, that's correct. So here at this moment, click on refresh option. Okay, so for this organization, you can't see anything. Why you can't see anything? Since I haven't added any repository. So what I will do, first I will add one repository and I will commit, and then you will able to see that repository here. So stop sharing your screen. First I will share my screen, then you will share your screen again.
Yeah, stop it.
Yeah. So let me know if everyone able to see my screen. Now I will show you like how we can create a repository. Okay, so we already created organization. So inside this organization, since I am a member, okay, I am member, I should be admin. Okay, this one is not my email ID, this one is my different account email ID. So that person is all, like that email is also having member access, but I am owner. Okay, I have all the access. So I can create repository, I can remove, add any members. Okay, so how I can manage members? So if I want to remove this member, go to here, cancel invitation. Okay, these two are showing pending invitation. Let me refresh this page first. Now only we have one pending invitation, since Venu, so he already selected that invitation, so that invitation is not here. So I can go and I can cancel this invitation. Now we have zero pending invitation, and as a member we have two member. I am a owner and he is a member, so he will have only read access. If I want to give him read and write access, then I need to change it here, manage or change role from member to owner. Then he will get write access, but I will not give write access to anyone, otherwise you may delete some file and later on we will face some problem. So you will have only read access for this particular repository, what I for this particular organization what I created. But if you want to learn in detail, you can create your own organization and you can do all these steps activity. Okay, now if I want to remove any user which I already added, that also I can do here. You will get remove from organization. If I will remove him, then he will lose this particular access for this particular organization. Okay, but I don't want to remove him, so this fine. Here you can see projects, so we don't have any projects. So if I want, I can create project. Okay, new project. So I will select all the default option. So one private project got created. Okay, and you can track, you can put any details here. So generally like project works we don't do here, but they added this option also, and you can utilize this option. But this kind of thing we do on Jira. So here we will be more focused on repository. Here we will create repository. So repository means folder structure where I will keep all the my shared resource. So what repository I want to create? First repository I want to create documents. So in this particular repository I will keep all the documents and I will share with everyone. So this will be my private repository. I will add one readme file. So you can see here the default branch or main branch name is main. I don't want this branch, I want master branch. So I can go in setting and I can change this main to master. Generally in project we follow master. Click on update. Okay, So this one is done. So again, I need to go on organization. I'm not sure that is. Let me go back. Okay, so I will create repository again. Okay, documents. This will be public or private. I want to make it private, so only members will able to see. README file I want to add, and then here you can see now my main branch is master branch. Okay. And inside this branch we have only one README file. So what I will create, I don't need to do anything here. So this repository is created here. Here one thing I can do, I can create multiple branch. Okay. So generally for document we don't need, for application we need multiple branch based on environment. That we will do later on. I will explain that later on. So this repository is created inside my this organization. Now this is on server. I want to link, or in technical term we term as a clone. I want to clone this repository in my local. So how I can do? Select this option, open with GitHub desktop. Okay, but at this moment, last time what I did, I log in with another account, so I need to switch to another this account again. So go to reference, sign in. Okay, so here I need to cancel this stage. So first I need to come on my actual account. So this is my actual account. Now I will sign in, otherwise that will be linked with another account, so that will create problem. So I am connected with my Git repository. Next, what I will do, how I can clone my Git repository in my local repository. So for that, what you need to do, file and then clone repository option you need to select. Okay, so what it will do, it will show you all the repositories available in your organization or in your account. Okay, so here you can see these all are organization, different organization already created in my account. Just now I created banking project customer onboarding one. This particular one created just now, and inside this I created one document. So this is my organization and this is my folder. So my folder is documents, and where it will go to this location. I don't want to put in this location. I created separate folder for this entire training program, so I want to keep there. So what I will do, I will go to desktop and investment banking, and here I want to create one folder. That folder name I will give Git and inside this folder I will create this document repository, and that repository will be my local repository. So what I am doing here, on server I created one repository. I want to sync that repository from my local, or I want to clone that repository in my local. Until unless I will not clone in my local, I will not able to do any change in that repository. I can do on server also, we can do, but that will be very difficult. So that's why what I will do, I will clone that one from server to local, and then in local I will do whatever I want. So click on clone. Now if I go to that folder, so that is inside my desktop, investment banking. So here you can see inside Git folder this repository is created. This is my local. Okay, what I want to do now, inside this repository I want to keep all my documents. So what all documents I have, so I want to share with all you guys. Okay, so how I can share with you, so I will select this two document since I want to share with you. So let me copy cut from here, and then I will go inside this particular document and I will paste it here. Now what I did, I updated my local repository. So here I am updating my local repository. If I updated here, then if you go to your center repository, view organization repository, inside this document folder I have, till this point I have only readmd file. I updated my repository, but still I have only readmd file. What does it mean? Whatever repository I cloned from here to my local, I updated my local, so that will be accessible in my local only. If I want to make it accessible for everyone, then what I need to do, I need to commit that from local to, first time I pulled everything from central to local. So there you can see this readmd file. Now what I will do, I will do reverse. I will commit from local to central. So whatever things are there in my local, it will come on server, and then it will be accessible for everyone. Whoever will be part of this particular organization, everyone will able to see all those documents. So at this moment, I think his name, I forgot, Veera or Venu, what was your name?
Vasant.
So inside this document, you can also see only readmd file, correct? You know how to reach to this place, or I need to guide you? Vasant, you know steps, or I need to guide you?
I know sir.
Okay, so just go inside this document folder and check, do you have any other file or you have only readmd file?
I only have readmd file, man.
Yes, so ideally I haven't committed on server, so that's why that is accessible only for me on my local. If I want to visible that documents for everyone, then I need to commit. So how I will commit? So I already updated here in my local. Now I will go to Git desktop, and here you can see two new file added in my local. So this Git desktop is cloned with my local, synced with my local. So whatever you will do update, or whatever change you will do in local, it will be visible here. You can see here green symbol is there, means these two are new file. Okay, now what I will do, this is my existing file. Okay, I will open this file. So I did some change in this particular file. Now if I will go to git desktop, you can see this third file is also there, and this color is yellow, means I updated this file. If you will delete any file, then you will get red color. So by color you can identify. These two are new file, this one is updated file. What I updated, I added this line. So whatever you can see in green, that is added one. Whatever you can see in red, that one is deleted one. I haven't deleted this one, but still sometime it will show same thing will be deleted and same thing will be added. Overall this one is zero, means neither we deleted neither we added, but sometime it will show you. Wherever you will see green one, means that one you added. Whenever you will see red one, means you have deleted in this particular file. Now everything is in my local. I want to push this thing on central repository. So first you need to write here summary. So summary I am giving initial document commit. Description is optional. Click on this commit to master. Now here you will get push origin, and here also you will get push origin. I prefer this one. Okay, so everything is here. Inside history you will get initial commit, first time when I cloned it in my local, then I committed this three file. So this one is in history, so all history will be visible here, and who committed you can easily track. Okay, so be careful whenever you will commit anything. So very like you should not commit something wrong, it will be easily trackable. Okay, so and it we can revert also, like whatever commit I did, someone can come and he can revert. Now whatever code was there in my local, I committed on server. So if I go to server here, just let me refresh this one. For refresh I will click on this. See, all folders are here. Now Veera, what you need to do, you need to share your screen. Sorry, I forgot your name again. So you need to share your screen, Venkat, I think.
Vasant,
sorry. Okay, you share your screen?
Yeah, sharing, sir.
Okay, so now you also refresh your page. On top left. Yes.
Yeah, now this it came.
So
2 minutes ago.
Yes. So whatever commit I did on central repository, now it will be accessible to everyone. Okay. So now okay. How you will clone this thing in your local? So again you need to go on Git desktop. Go to Git desktop. Okay, refresh this particular page.
Yes.
Yeah. So you can also see this.
Appeared.
Yes. Select that one. So location wise I'm not sure you want to maintain in this location.
No problem.
Okay, click on clone.
Yes, it came, sir.
Okay, and yeah, it's already cloned. You can also check in history. Go to history, you will able to see all the commits and everything. After change there is one history option. Yes, you can see like first time I committed, second time with my name. How come? Okay, fine, leave it. So these two are commit. Now you go to your local folder, you will able to see all the files there in your window browser folder. Go to folder on your bottom. Yeah, on your bottom you can see a folder.
Not
this one. Your device folder.
Okay.
Yeah. Go to that particular location where you.
10x. Yes.
Okay, yeah, so you can see everything is here now. Okay, so for everyone, like we will collect your email ID and we'll give access to everyone. Okay, so by tomorrow, like, we will provide you one form. You need to fill that form, so we will get all the email ID. Everyone will get access, so everyone need to create Git account, then use same email ID for that Git account and provide us that email ID. Then you need to install Git desktop, whatever setups we explain you will get in this video also, or if you can remember, you can follow the all those setups, and then you can clone this particular repository in your local. So let me know if anyone has any doubt. Okay.
We can also use GitHub commands, right?